Diabetes World, changing your mindset.
Good to have you on another edition of Peace Show. It's my pleasure to have you join us today. This is the people who is the
Diabetes World, changing your mindset.
To wake up at the show, the governorship pastor of Anambra State, Dr. Godwin Maduka. Doctor, it's my pleasure to have you today for this work. You're welcome, sir. Doctor, you're part of the PDP tickets, and you got 5 votes. Now you can send me.
Well, as for the first time, I was born without politics. And you said that cardboard. And that cardboard is among people I don't even know. I was surprised that I didn't have cardboard. But the people I knew, which is the majority of people, started doing it. And at the home of the place. The people in Anambra and around Nigeria knew, and knew that too. I will have that 80%, 80% and above. I'm going to the primary and I want to hear giving people to come and discuss that. So that doesn't make me feel. That our system is flawed. We don't adopt democracy. We have to stick to the rules. And if we're going to grow as a nation, and then increase as a country, we have to do overall that great part of the world that will grant us to what we want to start. It will not work. And we cannot compete in the world stage. We don't have God for the peace.
Okay, so ideology and ideology of the party so far match together. We need the kind of person you are.
No, one thing was clear. The parties or the party that we know about and happen. They have some people that believe that they are ones that should say that he becomes a governor, he doesn't become a governor. So, I and the rest of my number of people are coming with suggestions to you. Now, the party or the parties I'm looking at have to be one that believe that we have to serve. Because if we do not, I think the best advice I can give you, if the governorship candidates demand that people want. So I'm actually trying to let them know.
What you have to think about that you remember the problem in Nigeria. Particular party that you know, James, let me tell you that you have two other parties that you know and that are good. Is it what you're trying to tell us?
Well, I'm trying to tell you that a big league, which I decided to join until this last problem that I had, that yes, I will give them the last benefit of doubt, even to the last minute, to get it right. Because if they don't, the impacting or the impact that I desire to go into, but a lot of these factors are important. Have to be the kind of party that consume my ideology, serving the opponent of the party. And I'm telling that I'm about to go to the party.
Since you already know the platform, we're not asking you here. To make sure that the campaign gets close to every nook and cranny in Anambra State. We need the own value to cohere these two editorial programs in Anambra. What are the missionaries coming down?
Well, you know, I'm glad for your question. Since I wasn't a conventional politician, you know, the primary election, I was actually doing general election. I was taking my message to the people, and that's why he paid off now. So, machinery and brandy is what I have done. And with the people, they couldn't have enough of that. So, I knew a lot of folks in the Ubuntu government, and I got to meet people outside the party. So those people that believe in me, they're still out here. They're still out here.
Waiting for you.
Waiting for me.
Finally, what are your necessary strategies for Anambra?
Well, if you're from Anambra, you know I've had that strategy for a long time. Aha! Much bigger aspect of society and continue what I have to do.
Such as
business growth in the area of education, the new graduates, elementary, secondary, and adult education. I don't have to do the humanitarian process and work in the part of the government, which is very important because if I'm allowed to be in the state, will be the most literate state in Nigeria. So that part I continue. In the area of health, you know that I'm building the college medical design, the libraries, from Sahara. You know, we will be using the common line of Africa from the 1999 college, the giant strength that I'm using to bring the image of continuous and blind people. When I left one of the students, we came to Harvard graduate, we came to the four professor, and built 6 large hospitals, and maintained it.
Six large hospitals.
So I came back here and built another big, big hospital, which I gave to the church to handle it for them. Before I went home, we built this building, the 17th floor. No office. And the reason of letting me pay governance is not the money for any of that. Because I am talking about the right. The normal city I was born with fathers with that house. So in the area of health, there's a grand way from Nigeria to overseas. So I want to be able to reverse that so that we don't lose a lot of money to have an account for the authority. I told them in the area of ICT, our people should be educated on ICT. We should go ahead and know how to do that. We should produce our own food. We should get involved with this technology and letting the world advance up. I told them in terms of agriculture, feed yourself. Let agriculture produce something that all of us can look forward to be doing. As a governor, I'll make sure that I have some money set aside for. Well, the people so that they can start giving and start then the power agriculture, which would mean that if after that they take what they can consume, go to buy the rest of them and then sell the or give out the people that really do much for themselves. I have talked about the area of transportation, air, land, and sea. will make sure that people that are doing that will do it right. So these are the things that I've been preaching about.
Most of the analysts profess to have a good idea and vision for a number of things. Yeah. On nature and power is the commercial part of the service. If you follow
you know, yesterday I met the asthmatic, which is the association of medicamented drugs, which is the main person that is in charge of the drug market. Yes. On the channel in the 60s, 70s, 80s is better than on the channel today. Why is it that when you come to South Africa, it looks like in a war zone? Given the opportunity to become a governor, our structure on it, we will rebuild on it. We have a way to make the roads, and there will be decent buildings. If you have a pattern, as the place in your play, we will make sure we will get you to the 20% of the place and bring that in pattern. But we can't bring that in pattern if you go to that. Yes, and that's how you play your school fees. That's how you treat your family. Or Cameron shall go on that way. So, on the charm was made the structure that he built. It was Cameron generated the revenue to it after we rebuilt on it. So that if the Western world would like to come and invest in it, the rest of Africa will come back on it, which is at the Bank of River Niger. Speaking of that, Oliver Niger, the bank shouldn't be a waste of thing. It shouldn't be a place where people forget. You go to see things running around the bank. The waste management is so poor. How do you attract an international company to come to the state? Oliver Niger, Nigeria. And he lost his military. Whenever we regret that bank should be there should be shops along that end. We should get rid of the things and the waste. Okay? And find a way to contain those things. On the chat should be a different place. On the chat is our original tab. We go to the word no.
You said that you have the mountains to change the story that you get to the land. You don't understand that the skipper has nothing to do with the story. But before you answer that question,
PD's World, changing your mindset.
Welcome back to GODWIN MADUKA. Today, I'm a guest. His Excellency, Dr. GODWIN MADUKA, he's here with me today to be discussing about governance, politics, and him as a person, what he has to offer in a number of ways. But before we go, I ask you, do you have a guidance to meet a black man with me and a skin color? He's too different. And probably that would be my message.
Sometimes when I say I'm uncomfortable in this, what I've asked, you realize what I'm talking about if you already not. I grew up in the hinterland of Virginia. Don't remember precisely. Friday, I didn't even go to church. Or even go to order. Growing up. So I was farming in the village, feeding goats and sheep. Even when it rained, you had to go out there and bring the leaves for the goats. Otherwise, they would cry all day. And then from there, you will make some money by either selling the goats or coming for the food. And we also did the Yorker agriculture. We have to go to the farm and cultivate what they want to eat. And some of us weren't so lucky enough. I wanted to be your teacher. Imagine what it is for a 15, 16 year old young man to climb the palm trees, bring down the nuts, take it to the local place where we have the oil, and then when you get the oil, put in the tea, coffee, tea, oil, and you carry it in your head and go sell it to the market. From there, you can get the money to which you go to, and then feed your family.
How do you intend to make a black man understand himself better?
The black man has to realize that I have dissected many women in my medical education. You really can't tell the difference between
white bread,
or Korean bread, or Indian bread. You can look at the skeletal part and find out how to look. But look at the brain, everything is the same. The intelligent part of the brain is the same. So what made me realize which after going through that, I realized that intelligence is exposure, challenge. For some people are naturally intelligent, but they don't choose a race. Okay. So it's in Patamarica from Nigeria. Being a triple professor in America. Yes, I'm teaching people from all over the world. In the clinical professorship that I do, people from Korea, people from America, people from UK, people from Africa, every part of the world.
You teach them?
I teach them so that they can save life. I can help you so many wealth of information and knowledge.
It's okay, but it's been wonderful speaking with you, but I remember you had an accident. If you finally become the governor of Panama State, what kind of policy are you going to run? Is it going to be open government or open secret governments?
Well, it's going to be open. People have to get involved in governance. You never knew who is going to give you the best ideas. You see, I'm trying to change the myth about governorship. If you're going in India to be this absolute power, you will answer for that at the end of your life. If you're trying to be the governor of a state, it's almost like being a reverend father or a priest in a church. Your people's life depends on you. You don't have to be a killer when you get a gun and shoot somebody. You can be a killer as a governor when you decide not to listen to
policies.
Make new policies that will save people's life and make their life on earth to be better than what it could be. So as a governor of Anambra State, people will bring this in. We'll make the state very rich. We'll make the poor educated. We'll make the people living in Anambra State to be example of what governance should be.
Wow! It's been wonderful experience. You are really, in fact, we pray you get this ticket and we and actually bring the sweat of knowledge into Anambra State, into Igbo land, into Nigeria, and be able to go a long way changing who we are today. Now, before I leave you, what do you say can happen to Anambra? I should get to you. Because your part of getting this ticket again. Please, watch this message to Adam.
Indian number, you know me. I'm like a bird on the top of the tree, everybody can see. You know what I'm about. You know what I think about you. So the message is, we have an opportunity now to go back to what we used to do, the land of greatness. So I'm telling you today that I will guarantee you, as I pray, that upon becoming a governor, I will make sure that everybody's carried that on and nobody's left behind. You see me doing the campaign. I do not act. That's who I am. I don't use words or education or whatever, because I, as a Christian, know that I can only talk to you. I can say, if you're going to do it, I'm doing it. You can have a and put it to work. I'm ready to work with you as well. To make me able to restore our heritage. And everybody will carry that on.
Thank you, Your Excellency. It's been wonderful speaking with you. I appreciate your time coming on the show. Thank you so much. It's been wonderful speaking with His Excellency, Dr. GODWIN MADUKA, the Governorship of Health and Animal State. It's been a wonderful session with him. And I said it all. If you want to do it, you can do it. So he is ready to bring back the glory of Anambra. And you know what that means? Anambra glory is rested. Southeast glory will be rested. Nigerian glory will be rested. I think this man is making a head of sense. I don't see what Anambra will be decided. And I sure feel they should be able to put their questions. That's what everything we have to say today on this show. And if you need this interview, you can watch it online on www.radiosworld.tv. Remember, subscribe to our YouTube page. Share with
the information. We love you. We love our life. Beauty's World, changing your mindset.